What is happening, PGA DFS fans? Welcome to another one of my PGA DFS top five videos. And this one is the values for the John Deere Classic. And while we're all gearing up for the Open Championship next week, and of course, the Millionaire Makers that'll come with it, plenty of ways to get into those Millionaire Makers without spending what the actual price is for the entry through satellites this week. And of course, the Olympics in a couple of weeks, but still, the John Deere Classic provides us plenty of opportunities to win life-changing money. And last week, well, if you'd watched this video as I go into my transparency corner here, you might have been one of those guys that made a ton of money last week there at the Rocket Mortgage in Detroit as well. Got to be honest, this might be a first for me, but I had all five guys make it through the cut. Not only did I have all five golfers make it through the cut, but I also had all five golfers get in the top 25 and four of them get inside the top 10. Let's start with Bo Hostler. He came in a tie for 25th. Then I went to Troy Merritt. Well, he came in a tie for second. Hank Lebioda, well, he continued that great form, tied for fourth. Cam Davis, he came in first. Sung J.M. tied for eighth. That is an A+. I can't do any better. The average salary that came out would have left you $37,800. So you'd have been able to roster anybody. Sadly, that would have left you with Bryson DeChambeau, say, and about $800 left on the table. Would have easily gotten to the cash, but you would have had to drop one of those guys unless you wanted to leave a ton on the table. Still, you centered your lineups around these golfers, like I saw some of you did. I saw a ton of screenshots. Then you paid off. So let's go ahead and try and make it two for two. As sometimes the first reads, which is my first top five video of the week, sometimes the first read is the right read. So let's go ahead and jump into my top five values this week. We're going to start with number one on the other end of the board, Kyle Stanley. Coming in at 7,900 this week on DraftKings, 9,900 on FanDuel. His course history, well, he's one of the best iron players. So obviously when he gets that iron going, it is a course where you can take advantage of strong iron play. So an 18th, this was actually in 2019, I should say. They didn't have this tournament last year. Missed the cut the year before that because he's a guy that when the irons go, he's not a good enough putter, long enough off the tee, or good enough around the green to make up for that. So no surprise there. But he's on a good run of form, 41st and 54th in his last two. But he's made the cut in each of the last five. And we just need consistency this week with how variable and how weak this field is. So Kyle Stanley, he'll be the number one. When we look at strokes gain rank, I just mentioned he's 33rd on the approach, top 33, 61st off the tee, 115 around the green, and 197 putting. Yikes. Keith Mitchell, he's a guy that I'm going to use as one of the values this week. A golfer that we've paid 8,000 plus for in the past month or so. Coming in at 7,400 this week. Pretty good value given the fact that he's had a top 10 here at the John Deere Classic. A couple of years ago, 2018 for him, Kim coming in seventh. And he has a couple of top 10s in the last 11 weeks as well. Now, I know he missed the cut 2 weeks ago, did not play at the Rocket Mortgage last week. Still, I would say TPC River Highlands, not a Keith Mitchell course. John Deere Classic, yeah, sure. Easy course, bomb it away, good iron play, get hot with the putter. Kind of Keith Mitchell's MO, as you see, ranked 18th off the tee, 159 in the approach. As long as he hits a lot of greens, he'll be fine. 199 around the green, 142nd putting. My next golfer, another golfer that has played really consistently lately. That's Patrick Rogers, checking in at 7,400 as well, 9,300 on FanDuel. Course history, 2 years ago, came in 43rd. Also, a couple of more pretty decent starts here. So for Patrick Rogers, who's made a number of cuts in a row, including 41st and 76th in his last two. 76 is not that great. He's been around the leaderboard, though. He's a guy that gets hot off the tee. As you can see, ranks 60th. Gets very hot with his putter at times or can be ice cold. He really goes either way. 83rd is what that equates to for the year. On the approach, that's where he's been losing strokes this entire year, but they've gotten better over the last month, which is why we've seen him make the weekend. He's ranked 203rd. Like I said, getting better. 105 around the green. Okay, my fourth value on the board. This guy is almost the most obvious play every single year here at this golf course. It's Zach Johnson. If he was 9,000 or above, which he's been most of the time at this tournament, I would say don't play him. But at 8,500, a guy that hasn't missed the cut, has a bunch of top 10s, has had a better year, came in 25th a couple of weeks ago at TPC River Highlands too. You got to look into it. Plus, his putter has gotten hot again. He's ranked third this year in strokes gained putting. 90th around the green, 120th on the approach, and 163rd off the tee. But we know that doesn't matter all that much here. Now, the last 2 years or two times this event has been played, it's been his worst two starts in the last, oh, I would say 8 years, given the fact that he has five top tens previous to that. And I think the other finish might have even been like 14th. So for Zach Johnson at 8,500, I think it's great value, especially that he's had a better year and more consistent than in years past when he's come to this event and still been able to get it done. Speaking of getting it done this year, basically done everything but win, Patton Kizzire. This guy is a little bit of an enigma most recently and closed with a fantastic round on Sunday. He's got a top third back at the Charles Schwab Challenge. So he seems to like these easy events that are easy to hit fairways, unlike TPC River Highlands, where that golf course is a little bit harder than especially what he saw last week at the Rocket Mortgage and especially what he'll see this week at TPC Deer Run. For Patton Kizzire, we know his MO now. He likes low-scoring, easy events. Well, this is that, and you can see from course history, 30th a couple of years ago, plus I believe he's got another top 10 here as well earlier on in his career. So at 8,900 on DraftKings and 10,200 on FanDuel, I think he presents some really good value this week. 66 on the approach and 11th on the green putting. So we love those two stats combined. One of the best in those two stats combined this week. Plus, it's going to leave you with roughly $9,000 or $10,000 left. There's some plenty of golfers in that range that we like, including Russell Henley, Sung Jae Im, and the alike. So really like this core to start. Let's go 5-1 again, just in case you missed any. Kyle Stanley, Keith Mitchell, Patrick Rogers, Zach Johnson, and Patton Kizzire. So until next time, everybody, it is the Open Championship next week. And let me tell you, that comes quickly. It's a Thursday morning start, 2 or 1 a.m., typically around 1 a.m., and the content just comes hot and heavy for you. So stay tuned for that. But of course, before we get to the Open Championship, let's win some money this week at the John Deere Classic. Good luck, everybody, and we will see you on the other side. Cheers.